on this episode of the Realmatic Podcast.
It's cloud chasing for sure. It's cloud chasing, man.
Do what you gotta do, gang.
Yeah.
It's just like, why do we gotta play with Jesus? Why we gotta play with Jesus like that, bro? Jesus is the most abused savior of all time, bro. He is the most abused religious leader.
They don't expect him to come back, bro. They don't think he's
gonna
come back.
Nah, real shit.
Like, they ain't gonna have to deal with that, man.
What you gotta do, gang? Like,
why? And I watched the video, bro. It has nothing to do with that, unless he's saying, you know.
Damn, I'd love to tear that tank, sir. Damn! You fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? You know who I am? What the fuck was that? You're about a weird motherfucker, aren't you? Hey, where are you giggling? Hey, don't walk away yet. I'm not gonna talk to you. I don't do that shit. I don't swing that way. What do you mean? I've never heard that shit before. I've never heard that.
What?
Tear my tank.
So what should I do? Should we get it done, or?
What the fuck don't you get? Get the fuck away from me, bro.
For what?
Just get the fuck away.
So, I never got a clear answer if...
Bro, are you fucking for real? Just shut up and go.
As he fought the system.
Coming from two different sources.
Yeah, bro, I was in the Matrix, bro. I had to hit a knee on their ass.
The weekend's crazy though. I deep down think I was just a part of like a satanic ritual, not gonna hold you.
Damn.
Yeah, bro. Them boys was crazy. He brought the moon. He brought the moon. He had like these dancers that was in the all red and they was just like in the red cloaks, bro, going crazy. I was like, hey yo, I'm gonna need you to figure it out, man. We on.
Marlon, you disrespectful, bro.
You
disrespectful, bro. You said, I hear you, nigga. I hear you making that noise.
No, because I can imagine this bitch is just hurling in a bag. And this nigga, I know how Russell moved. Russell would not pay attention to your ass. When he wants to see some shit and he really excited, he will ignore the fuck out your ass and push, move. We'll get to the back. This nigga at Rolling Loud, dude. He was for like, bro, I swear to God. I know she had to get behind this nigga like, bro.
It's because no one else was paying attention to that going on. It was like in the weekend here, and then there's a girl throwing up.
And then at his point, his care is like at zero, so I know for sure,
bro. Because I'm like, bro, I've been
What I would have paid for a picture of that? I swear to God, I would have paid so much money for a picture of that in real time. I swear to God, it was crazy.
The other girl throwing up was hilarious, bro. Like the black people in front of us, like it was funny, but like the black lady in front of us, like she looked at me and she looked at her, and she was like, no. You want to move? Like, I gotta shift it over, give her some space to do what she had to do. If you check the chat, you will see the satanic ritual that I speak of. If you want to throw that in there somewhere, Ben.
Okay.
Yeah. Them boys is, if you see them, look at them girls. They throw it, they throw in the coat like this. Praising the moon. I was a little like, oh, all right, man.
Oh, yeah, they do look real. Yeah. The way they dancing and shit.
Bro, they was praising their moon, like witches. Bro. Yeah. But the moon was crazy, though. I was like, yo, why did that look like that?
Hey, you got to get it out the mud, bro. You got to, you know, get that Illuminati money.
Hey, man. That's what you got to do. He sold out the Benz.
So. Hey, y'all selling y'all soul, bro?
I feel like I sold my soul last night to this.
Damn.
My soul in question now.
It's too late now.
Damn, not with the soul.
Marlon, no, he felt it in Playboy Cardi set, bro.
No, bro. You know, every time I keep looking at these videos from back, I keep forgetting we was moshing the majority of them shit. So I'm sitting here like, damn, bro, I feel like I'm missing gaps of time No, niggas were getting lit. Like, bro, like, I was pushing niggas. That shit, bro. Like a real experience, bro. Niggas were really getting violent in the mosh pit. And every time I had to, like, recenter, I could see this nigga in the distance. Because he was never close to me. He always was in the distance. All I see is him. This nigga neck was off his shoulder, bro. This nigga, all I see is hair. He was in a zone, eyes closed in the pit. Like, bro, I swear to God, you didn't see with your own two eyes. Like, this shit was some crazy shit. I was like, and I can't even get to it. I had to sit there and watch it happen. Like, mm-hmm. This is crazy, dog.
This is what it's crazy. But welcome back to the Realmatic Podcast.
Yes, sir. Woo! Hey. Woo! Got the clapping sound.
Right.
And it's clapping and explosion. Let's go.
Hey, man, before we get started, right? So, Rock. Mm-hmm.
What?
I give you $20 if you can guess the artist of this song, right? You only get one guess. You only get 10 seconds.
Only 10? Okay,
you ready?
Okay. Yeah. Yeah,
I'm only gonna give you one line. I'm not gonna give you multiple lines. All right.
Okay.
Shio.
Wait. Kid Cudi.
What?
Wrong.
What did you say? My bad. What,
say again.
Shio.
What am I?
That is so vague, bro.
What am I giving him? Right? What am I giving him?
Let me see if I can give you.
I have to give you the artist or the song. Yes.
Give me the bar. After
the artist of the song.
Yes, the artist of the song. Yeah.
Oh, the artist of the song. Yeah, I need a better sound to it.
I got you. Yeah, come on, bro.
I can't think of it. Who is it?
Damn, Burna Boy.
Oh, it is Burna Boy? Yeah, yeah, I just downloaded the project. I haven't listened to it yet.
Damn, you couldn't guess that, though? Mm. You knew he was African? Mm. I didn't tell Marlon because I knew Marlon would have got it.
I didn't think about it.
Yeah, I knew Marlon would have got that shit.
Yeah, I'm new to the Burna Boy thing, man. I'm
gonna lie to you. It's the fact that, bro, I think me and Ben got you beat. I swear, I thought you had me beat at one point. That me and Ben really got you beat. But I swear, we be in a pocket of obsessing over new shit.
Yeah.
I got you beat, bro. And I don't talk to you. I be
Lone
You team. Think you got me beat, though?
I got you beat by, like, the slimmest margin. I feel like
no, you don't, like, nigga. No, you don't.
I got you beat by the slimmest margin.
Where you getting that from, bro?
Man, say where you get the info from.
I feel like in this year alone, I put you on to more shit than you put me on to.
We're not talking about that, bro. I'm saying, do you think, because I could have did that too. Come on, man. I could have did that. I just didn't do it. I could have did that. I just didn't do it. We talking about who got the most expensive music knowledge. You think your knowledge is more expensive than mine? How?
Sure. Yeah.
How, bro?
I just feel like I dabble in more genres than you. I feel like I dabble in... Bro, I got a whole Caucasian playlist that I know for a
fact. Okay, me too.
I'm just saying, bro.
Me too. I have a favorite band.
Who's your favorite band?
Radiohead.
Radiohead is your favorite band?
Yeah.
Wow, that's interesting.
Fun fact for y'all.
Interesting.
Yeah, man.
Interesting.
I've just been like, I don't know.
Do you want to test this out, bro?
Bro, it's okay. We can test this out, bro.
All right, bro. We're going to find a way to test that out, bro. Because you tripping bro, right now,
I
bro.
I got you beat, bro. I know, don't get me wrong, bro.
Don't get me wrong. You have a beautiful music taste. It's beautiful, but it's not touching my shit, dog. You're not touching me. You're not touching me, bro. You're not touching me. I know.
Beautiful, nigga.
I know the history of it, man. Like, I know the beginning, bro. I
do, bro.
Bro, I'm in there, bro.
The 1972, like, okay.
Yeah,
grandpa.
Like, come on, bro. You don't know shit bro. For real,
my,
dog.
My shit
you don't even listen to bars
me,
like that, bro. You don't even listen
bro,
to bars,
I do listen
like,
to
that,
bars
bro.
Like that.
You don't,
I
bro.
Do listen to bars.
You
I do.
Don't.
I do.
You don't.
I do.
I do. Don't.
I do.
I don't know about that, Marston.
What you know? What you not going to do is, I do. You're not going to lyrical miracle me to death, bro. I do.
You don't never name nobody bars, bro. You never do that shit.
What
you don't listen to music for that.
I do listen to music for that.
You don't. The last nigga at bars you like was Denzel Curry. Denzel Curry is trash in the bar
compartment. I was talking about the project. I ain't talking about his bars.
Nigga, nah, you said he had bars.
But what's the point of the project if they ain't got no bars? Oh, damn, Mar.
You're not
feeding your claim, Mar.
Listen, No. That's because this band just hates Denzel Curry in general. They have a weird hate for Denzel Curry. It wasn't even a fair bias. Like, he legit hates Denzel Curry. Like,
Denzel Curry, Chance the Rapper, corny level. Man, it's about the same.
That's a stretch. Denzel Curry is way more cool than fucking Chance the Rapper.
He's not, bro. Yes, nigga's whack, bro.
Chance been doing the same shit he been doing since he started. At least Denzel Curry did three different stages.
The same drugs no more.
I'm just saying, bro. Chance still wearing a fucking three head. Cut that bitch out. Do something different. Weird ass nigga. Every time I see him,
he's making money off them threes, bro.
No, bro. Every time I see Chance, I just no, bro. He's getting boring now. He don't do shit. He don't do the drugs. He don't get the bitches. He don't be in the clubs smacking no ass. What you do?
For
as much money as he made, he ain't got no ice. He ain't got no grill.
Denzel Curry don't do that shit either, though, bro.
Yes, he do, though. Yes, he do.
He's lame, man. Ain't nobody fucking with him in the club,
bro.
Who
fucking with Chance in the club?
Bitches is fucking with Chance in the club, bro. You know it, bro. You know they fucking with off the strip, bro. Yeah, bro. Don't nobody know who Denzel Curry is, bro.
If he went to Magic City right now, nobody would know him in Magic City, bro.
I promise you. He could walk down
and niggas don't know who Chance the Rapper is?
Yes, niggas know who Chance the Rapper is when he got that hat on, bro. Yes.
Yeah. Bro, if you see the three, you know it's him.
Yeah, bro. Come on, huh? All right, man. Let's get it started, though, y'all. Hey, man. Welcome back. This is episode 85 of the Realmatic Podcast. If you don't know, I'm Ben. I'm with my brothers, Rasan and Marlon. Hey. Bro.
A weekend, hey.
Spirit Airlines, bro.
Yeah. That's the best airline in the world, Ben.
Allegedly. Man. Did y'all hear about the employee that went off on the customer?
No,
bro?
I did not see that.
You got the video. I'm telling you, this video is lit, bro. I'm not even going to cap, bro. This video
I didn't know
lit.
How to feel about it.
Is it a bad lit? What are we talking, man?
It's
a
good lit, bro.
I need you to get back on social media, bro. You miss a lot of fun.
I know.
He got to stay off. He got to stay off.
No, bro. I'm telling you, miss a lot of fun, bro. Bro, you ain't see what Kanye did to Pete, bro. I did see what Kanye did to Pete.
He did.
He said that in there.
Yeah, he sent a picture.
I said, you ain't see that shit in real time like I did. I saw the shit when he posted it live. I was like, damn.
Dude.
Like, some
bro, this video is lit,
when you see it in real time.
Touch me ever in your life. Touch me first, and then you got in my face. Don't ever invade my face.
Get out of my
face.
Absolutely wrong, because I feel like as a man in this society, blah blah blah, we gotta be a step above and not fight women and not do that, even though in certain scenarios I can believe that sometimes, you know what I'm saying, they might need, I'm not defending it, but I do feel like at a point I can see why a man spaz out and do it, because sometimes they be pushing it. In that scenario, I can't really tell who's the right and who's the wrong, but I do feel
in the wrong.
I think they both in the wrong. I'm not gonna sit here and just give them. Like I gotta feel like they both in the wrong because I feel like y'all both are grown ass adults arguing in a fucking crowded ass airport, and y'all get to the point where y'all finna fight. That's just not what you don't want to have. That it's not a good look in general, especially as a black man arguing with a Latina woman or a black woman. It just don't look right. Look, it looks really bad regardless.
That video lit, man. That video lit, bro. But nah, they both in the wrong though, man. They both in the wrong. She's in the wrong for even touching the man. He in the wrong for provoking her. He was provoking her throughout the video. All in the face. I mean, this the thing, man. When you doing that type of shit, when emotions get that high, it's like, you already know. You just triggering motherfuckers at that point.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when she smacked that nigga, you got everything that's coming to you at that point, man.
You saw how she rolled on that floor, bro? Yeah. She wasn't ready. That man a gorilla, bro.
And you notice she did that when somebody came in the way. She smacked him when somebody got in the way.
Mm-hmm. Like, hoping that somebody else is going to defend
that's
her.
That's that bitch shit, man. Stop, bro. Stop hitting these niggas, man.
Hoping that
these niggas will hit you
and defend her. And I'm like,
these niggas will hit you,
bro. He was
going to
fuck her up. No, and I can't even really be mad at him about it.
Nope.
Like, like, yeah, we could be like, nah, that's a woman. Don't hit that woman. But it's like, bro, at this point, y'all got to learn. Stop hitting niggas.
Stop the violence, bro. Stop the fighting. We can't talk this out. Walk away.
No, she wasn't trying to swing on him when nobody else was involved. That's just crazy.
Then this nigga coming in the way. No, bro, don't hit that girl, bro. Don't hit. Shut the fuck up.
Like, that's not your business. Shut your ugly ass. Like, goddamn, you can get these hands.
Like, yeah, keep him away, but stop all that extra shit. Oh, you gonna fight him? You don't even know her, bro.
Yeah,
like, and then it be the niggas that they be trying to defend the hoes that don't give a fuck about them. She would not defend you in that same situation, nigga. She would not lend a hand to you if you needed it. So why the fuck are you going out your way to put yourself in danger?
Oh my God.
This man is irate.
Because I understand, like, really, I understand, protect the women. I get it. But, bro, that's not your bitch. Bro. You know, what you get? Get mind your business, bro. That's not your bitch, bro.
He was like
man, if you get
they're
your
both
ass
wrong.
Beat, what you
they're
get
both
your
in the wrong,
for?
Right?
Listen, don't die for a chick that's not your bitch.
She also is the
don't. That's the quote of the day. Like I just want to put it fit. Don't die for a chick that's not your bitch, bro.
Man, real shit, bro. Real shit.
I'm just like, I want to make that hit myself like a rainbow. Like, don't die for a chick. Like,
I'll be
bro.
Damned if I'm down for somebody else's chick. Bro. That's crazy.
What's like, bro, I meant you down for somebody else's chick, bro. That's all so crazy chick, right bro. Now.
See, and that's the thing. So, as you can tell, the guy is probably gay, right?
Oh, yeah, I didn't even think about that. Damn, you know what?
You hear what she's
right.
saying? She's calling him a faggot.
No, yeah, I mean, you know how they do. No. You know how they do. She was saying a lot of shit, bro. I think she was just trying to get under
that,
his skin.
But like, yeah, so like, he's probably gay, and they're like, "Oh, fight a man." They was trying. They was adding extra fuel to it because of his sexuality. It's just like, dog, come on now. She thought she could boss up on him because of that way, and then realized after the while, I was like, "Oh shoot, he is a guy. He a man. He got one
good little hit in too."
Bro, that's what I'm like. Dang, man.
Hit that
and she got multiple
over.
pushes on him. All of on it, bro.
It's not fair.
He's gonna
bro.
Be the case.
Ain't gonna be no case.
They're gonna be a case because she's gonna try to file some junk against him, saying, and then Spirit gonna get involved.
You got your ass tossed. You got your ass tossed by a black man airport. He gonna have a hard time. But bro, man, it is what it is. I feel like niggas fight every day.
That's crazy.
Niggas fight every day, B. Niggas die every day.
Nah, for real, bro.
That's crazy, bro. They was flipping around the airport. Just like when they fell over, bro.
Yeah,
just don't die. Don't
so
die.
You think he was gay though? I didn't even think about that. So he gay?
Does it change things?
But that's where it also added fuel to it from them and their perspective of things.
I just feel like why are we arguing? Two grown adults should not be arguing in the airport like that. It's probably early fucking the morning too. Like, what are we doing, bro?
What are they arguing about?
Hey, bro.
You're flying Spirit.
You know my girl.
It's Spirit.
Like, bro, what we doing, bro?
You're flying Spirit. That says a lot about what you're doing right now.
Mm-hmm. I told y'all, man, y'all got to stop fucking with these workers, man.
That leads to the next one, bro.
That leads right into the next one, man. So the Wendy's worker, he punched out a customer, man. So I ain't gonna cap, man. He rocked his shit, dog. I'm not gonna cap. Oh my god,
show
bro.
Me this shit. I even see it yet.
Damn, where that video at?
In the video. Show the video.
Also, before he started the video. Y'all seen that weird ass picture of like Kanye West on Lil Uzi and Steve Lacy?
He said, "Let me get this in there." bro.
I
had to get that in there, bro. I feel like it'd be a crime not to talk about that picture, bro. Because them niggas got matching tattoos. Like, bro, Kanye trying to be young so bad.
Yeah,
but that's like that's a weird group of niggas that had together though. Because like I understand Kanye fuck with Steve, but like having Lil Uzi in the mix, it looks weird, bro.
Uzi was just like.
And then, like, tattoos are like, we're here forever, technically. Like, it, to me, it's low-key hard. Because I
know
like
it is.
Like
I know it is. I know it's hard.
I was like, damn, I might steal that. But it's like, it's just a weird group of niggas, like, that ass, like, I don't know. Like, that's like some cult shit on the low.
Damn. Illuminati, bro.
I ain't gonna say Illuminati, but why would Kanye West, Steve Lacy, and Lil Uzi link up? That's so weird, the group of niggas to link up.
It is, though. It is. It's very random.
Uzi can't have as much money as he be acting like he got. Ain't no way.
What? You don't think so, bro?
You know what? Me saying
that. Pink Diamond,
bro.
Though.
Uzi got money.
I think Uzi get more money from stuff outside of music.
Yeah, probably.
I think he doing other stuff. Because he be really moving. Like, he ain't. He really got
a big fish. He a big fish.
I did not know it like that. He be moving like he really got bread. So
he booked for every show, every major performance. Lil Uzi is booked for. I feel like he's making money. I just feel like he's not dropping music that can like make him more money. I feel like his art ain't really improving. If you think about it,
bullshit.
What?
That's bullshit.
Yeah.
How's that bullshit?
How is his art not improving, bro?
Oh, it's gotten better over time.
That last part, I'm not talking about none of his past parts. I'm talking about that shit he just dropped.
That was for like the SoundCloud wave, man. My man went back into an old little pocket of stuff.
Dude, what you want this man to do though, bro? You say this every time,
he's a top rap, bro. I'm ready for some different. I'm ready for some different shit. Lil Uzi always came with the heat. I feel like we ain't had no real Lil Uzi heat in a little second, bro. Like I'm ready, like god damn, bro. I feel like I'm not even being a hater. Get your money, bro. But I feel he be teasing niggas so much. Oh, I'm gonna drop this album. I'm like, bitch, I don't care. Drop the shit. Like he post that shit. He's the only nigga who do that shit. He'll talk about some shit that'll never come out.
That's why they got the tattoo.
No. Then what Kanye do it, Kanye gonna drop some shit at some point. He'll talk his shit about it. But
Eternal Take just took forever. That's all.
Uzi got like three parts and they never drop. I swear to God, like Kanye, it's different because Kanye gonna drop some shit at some point. You know it's coming. Mm. It just might not be what you think it's gonna be. Uzi don't never drop it. Yeah, like he legit like.
But Steve Lacy getting this tattoo with Kanye West though—that's just so random. That had to be some just like spur of the moment type shit.
Hey Kanye, let's get tattoos.
Yeah, like that don't even make sense.
But it's like, how do them niggas link up? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like Kanye too old for that shit, bro. You that nigga almost 50 years old doing that shit.
Shit, crazy.
Old, bro.
But yeah, let's get back into this video though, man. So we got the Wendy's worker punch the fuck out this customer, man. Tell y'all, bro, y'all gotta stop fucking with these workers, man.
Nine tonight, we start with a brutal first-hand look at violence unfolding inside of Wendy's. What's happening up in Preston Sound? Fast food workers actually knocked a customer out cold after punching him right in the face.
Yo, my man said high fry, hit him with the fries.
Man. So basically, the customer was like, he had a problem with his order or something. He was complaining about it. Then old buddy just came around the corner and just rocked his shit.
Did he get him while he was like tying in his shoe, bro? My man was
I don't know, bro. I don't know what that man was doing, bro. But he rocked the shit. He loaded that shit back, bro. Like, nigga.
All the unemployment all in one fist.
Yeah, no, for real, bro.
Yeah, that nigga a fucking punch, bro. Damn.
No, dead ass, bro. Like, damn.
What my man that Tyson shit, bro.
Like, dead ass, bro.
Was it even worth it, bro? Just
that's a question you gotta ask these niggas. Like, is it ever worth it for real? Like,
bro, they be hiring the wrong niggas, bro. They be hiring the wrong niggas, bro.
I went to a Waffle House last night. Yeah, I went to a Waffle House last night. I ordered my food and I was like, yeah, I want sausage or whatever with my All-Star. She comes to the window with it. Do y'all, if y'all didn't know, Waffle House got drive-thrus now or like windows at the front.
Oh,
now.
Yeah,
it's weird. So she comes over to the thing and she got like, it has bacon. I'm like, oh yeah, I said sausage. She said, nah, you said bacon. I was like, nah, I said sausage. And she's like, all right, then that's gonna be $3.25. I was like, I ain't paying for the same stuff that I got right here. She got an attitude, bro. She throws my plate.
Whoa!
Damn! Throws my plate like up on the counter and like pops it open. And, like, he said, "Take the bacon." I'm like, "Oh shoot!" Oh,
whoa!
I'm like, anger my food. I'm like, "Yo, thanks, I guess."
I missed that.
She threw the plate at you.
Be rude.
Huh?
She threw the plate at you.
Did you threw it at like the cook, like real quick? Like, like, she got mad about it. I was like, "Yo, you." I was like, "I'm not about to pay for something that you can easily change." And she's like,
I'm gonna move back to Atlanta because I missed that. I missed that.
You missed that.
Nah, I get crazy in the world, bro.
I
get crazy.
That's what I want, bro. I missed the toxic.
Somebody said they was in Waffle House, right? And the nigga was cooking and he had like a little cold or whatever. So he had like a snot bubble that went inside the fucking pot and nigga kept cooking that shit anyway, bro. I said, what? Nigga ain't even say nothing, dog. Nigga ain't even say nothing, bro. That's nasty.
He ain't gonna say nothing, bro. He's gotta keep it cooking, bro.
Waffle House being the most toxic place on earth. I love it.
It's crazy.
It's crazy. But
going
bro.
Back to this Wendy's worker though, man, it's just like they're not getting paid enough, bro. So when you go up there, just be respectful, man. What's be respectful enough? And get your fucking food.
What's paid enough in fast food?
A livable
when
wage.
They don't already fast food isn't even food fast anymore, bro. Fast food is food. That's it. You get it when you get it.
Yeah. Facts. At this point, especially Popeyes.
Because. Popeyes has been around for 50 years, bro. 50 years. Ain't no way they've been around for 50 years moving like this, bro.
Yeah, that's crazy.
What you mean,
bro?
Them herbs and stuff.
They acting like they a dine-in, bro. Like, damn, why I gotta wait 20 minutes to get my food, bro?
I pulled up to a KFC the other day. Was like, I want a chicken sandwich or whatever. If you didn't know, KFC got a bustin' ass chicken sandwich. If y'all don't
not
know.
Better than Popeye.
Mm.
It's better than
Popeye.
Did you
try that Jack Harlow shit?
I did. That's why I got it. Like just the combo meal. Is that like,
it's good?
That sandwich is really bustin', bro.
Oh, I heard it wasn't, dog.
Really?
Yeah, I heard it.
No,
wasn't
I liked
that.
It. I don't know. I guess I got one that before that was like fresh out the grease because that joint was right there, crispy and nice. It was a quality sandwich.
Damn.
But I pulled to the KFC.
What about the mashed potatoes, like, bro?
I'm not a really big fan of their mashed potatoes.
Oh, okay.
That's fair.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of, like, because the gravy tastes weird. I'm good. But pull up a, it's going to be 35 minutes on chicken.
Whoa.
Huh? What?
It's KFC. Wait. I was like, 30 minutes. I'm like, all chicken? He was like, yeah. So you want anything?
What kind of shit they got going?
Your whole menu is chicken. I'm missing it.
Got no chicken, nowhere.
30 minutes. This ain't fast food, bro.
They do every piece they had in that bitch. Fuck.
I was like, nah, I'm good. The guy thinks.
What?
Not my bad. That's what I'm thinking, bro. I'm just like, y'all just don't want to cook.
Yeah, that's all that was.
Not want to cook. That's crazy. Y'all know that. What that's what I'm saying. Like, what's enough? What's enough pay for people doing fast food?
Just a livable wage, man. So they can pay their bills.
I'd probably say
like $15 an hour.
Bro,
that's not livable.
Why they not? How, bro? How is that not livable?
Bro, $15 ain't no livable wage, nigga.
What's a livable wage then, bro?
$20 an hour, like, bro.
That ain't no damn livable wage, bro.
But 15 is, nigga.
Yes, nigga.
No, people do
you
make
can
it
barely
shake
survive
dude,
off that.
People make it shake off $50 an hour, bro.
Yeah, bro. $20, you gonna be straight with that, bro. You gonna be straight.
I just can't stress, dog. They don't work hard enough for that.
They don't.
Like, they're select in the workers. There
they don't.
Like they really put their heart and soul into this, and like
they don't
take their time and do it. But a majority of them pull up to a McDonald's, bro. Half them workers ain't doing nothing, bro.
That's the thing, man.
I walk into a Wendy's. My man in the back, he's chilling. He slap the meat on the burger. I'm just like, I feel disrespected, bro.
I'm boy, like, I remember that shit.
They just slap it on the meat. No mayo. Bro, you ever get a McChicken and it's like a pound of mayo on them, bro? You're like, dog.
Oh, hell no.
That I hate that shit.
Come on, man. Take some pride in what you're doing a little bit.
Now, fucking wet ass lettuce, bro. What the fuck are y'all doing, bro? One slab of lettuce.
15.
One sheet of lettuce.
15 is their max, for real. Unless you hire up management. And even the managers at these places suck. So.
But like you said, they really don't deserve 15, bro. They really don't deserve it because it's just it's a low skill job and anybody could do it.
Yeah, so but I feel like everybody who works the job has the opportunity to be paid what they worth though. I feel like niggas working for $12 an hour in 2022 sounds so nasty. I ain't gonna lie to you.
I agree, man. I agree.
Because of inflation and the way the country is set up, bro, niggas can barely even make it. That's why niggas got three jobs. Like, and I hate to even say that, but that's a reality that a lot of Americans have to face because, bro, apartments are fucking $1,900 for like a one bedroom. You know what I'm saying? And it's kind of like, why is that?
Stupid.
You know what I'm saying? And that's like a national thing. That's not like, unless you finna live in the fucking middle of nowhere, which I know a lot of niggas are doing now, but bro, why the fuck do I gotta do that? Like, in every major city.
Exactly.
God, you guys don't live in New York or Miami or some shit, because then your ass really screwed.
No, dead ass. But yeah, man. Moving on. So we got Angela Yee. Angela Yee said the Breakfast Club is breaking up when in reality she's just leaving the Breakfast Club. So I don't know why she said that, because that's cap. But how y'all
why
feel
is she leaving?
She's getting her own show.
All right, so yes, so this is really exciting, but this is something that I've been wanting to do for years now, since way before the pandemic. I really want to have my own show. You know, I have my podcast, Lip Service, and I was thinking I would be able to get something like a weekend situation, you know, one day ease into having my own show again. It's always been a goal of mine to have that. Years later, they approached me up here at iHeart. Thea had to sit down with me and tell me that they are going to give me my very own show.
Yeah,
she's so mid.
She's mad mid, bro. She really is.
His name. Let's give her her flowers.
All right, too.
Angela Yee, I would say that you did a lot for the community. I feel like you was the balance.
In what way, though? In what way?
Listen. You was the balance of the three. You was the more sensible of the three. I feel like you actually was trying to get the interview and not be as tabloidy and salacious. I think in the later part of your career, you started to lean more towards the negative shit, but I feel like you was there to do your job, but ultimately, you didn't bring nothing exciting. You was just there.
Honestly, did she really bring the balance, though, bruh?
Charlamagne was the main.
It felt like it.
Yeah, it was Charlamagne and DJ, man. DJ Envy.
But I feel like Angela, you did. She provided something. I just feel like, bro, she was just mid. Like,
I don't believe in giving people flowers just because they was there, bro.
I ain't saying that, but I feel like she provided a part of it.
Angela's on the same level as Nadeska in every
That's a good ass take, boy.
I was like, if that's the way it was.
Bro, they the same, bro. They are the same.
I'm going to say, I think Nadeska was way more important than Angela Yee, bro.
Don't say that. Angela brought stuff to the Breakfast Club, like certain conversations, you know what I mean? She'll say some stuff. Yeah. Nadeska, boy, she used to sit there and just be like, she'll ask the question and just be like, all right, let's see how these two grown men fight it out. And not really.
And he did the same shit, if you think about it. Like,
bro,
like
she was instigating the hell out of it.
Angela was chilling, man. She was chilling a lot.
She would chime in.
It was only certain things. Like, certain things, like when Kodak, like those moments with like Kodak and Gucci. She got some highlightable moments that were just.
She
like,
don't got no highlights though, Rob.
Like, she just got highlights, bro.
She has highlights.
They don't have a highlight reel of her. They don't have a highlight reel of her, bro. They don't.
Best they do.
They don't have Angela Yee's best moments, bro. They don't.
I swear to God, I bet I can YouTube that shit right now, bro. I bet she do got.
Please do, please do, and I'll put that shit in. And I say I was wrong.
I
was wrong.
No, okay. No, she's gonna be pretty. She mid, bro. I know this nigga, bro.
Bro, is mid though. Gonna, and I mean,
bro,
look,
bro, we know she mid. I never said she. I started this off by saying she was mid. I'm just saying you cannot deny her contribution to the squad. She did what she was supposed to do. But her problem was this. She just wasn't bad. I think if she was bad, I think I should have been a little different. It's gonna sound so misogynistic. It's gonna sound so bad. Damn. But I think if Angela Yee was like a straight black, okay, I'm gonna sound messy and worse. I think if she was bad, I think she looked better. If she was way finer, I think this whole shit would have been different.
I just don't think radio was for her, man. Like, she's just like bro, she chill, bro. She chilling, man. It's like, you got to bring shit out of people. She's not doing
that. I just feel like she wasn't wild enough, bro. She was just like there. She was just professional. Chilling.
Yeah. She was very professional.
I didn't like how professional she was.
Fast forward, just looked it up on YouTube. Yeah, there are no Angela Yee best moments.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
You're lying.
No cap, bro, because she don't got none, bro. This is not a hot take, bro. Way. She just don't have good fucking moments for real. Like, she just there. Bro.
Yeah, DJ Envy got mad things. They like 3 years ago. DJ Envy best moments. Charlamagne funny moments, of course.
I know Charlamagne got all the moments.
Yeah, you right. No, Charlamagne, boy. That nigga crazy.
He sniffed the seat.
I was just thinking of that shit, bro. Like, the fuck is wrong with you?
He was talking about?
He was like, oh, he was talking to Logic, bro. I think he was talking to Logic.
So who raped your sisters?
Yeah, bro.
Who the hell raped your sisters?
Oh, man, I don't want to get into that. It's a little too personal.
I think that nigga got ADD.
So random. I'm find that
nigga got ADD,
he
bro.
He got to, bro. Because
he be sitting there, he be like, he just said a further to tell in his mind. So who your sister?
I don't want to talk about that. All right, my bad.
I didn't know he had on his ass.
They don't need her, bro. They really don't need her.
They said they're going to
replace her with somebody else, though.
But
they're gonna bring a young fine thing in there, and it's gonna be lit. That's it, bro.
Like, I heard it was supposed to be Remy Ma.
Mm-mm. Stop.
I mean, that's not too bad, but that's I ain't weird. Really fucking with that. Why is that weird, bro?
Weird.
But you might be getting a desk or some shit. Like, you
don't
might
get in the desk. Fuck no. Don't get in the desk.
Fuck no.
I don't that's like a lateral don't movement. Like, no, bro.
But no.
All she's gonna do is mm-hmm, and chime in like, bro, come on now.
She be chiming in at the worst moments, like,
yeah,
you trying to shut niggas up. Shut up, they're having a heated debate. Damn.
Hey, like, we're gonna go to the next topic.
Yeah, like, shut the fuck up. She remind me of Molly from goddamn ESPN First Take. Like, bro, shut
no!
up.
Oh, just shut
the fuck up, bro. You know what I'm talking about, too.
Everyone
bro.
Hates
the
Molly.
The desk is not that, about. Bro. You're being disrespectful. But don't do the desk like that. It's not Molly.
Nah,
Molly
is
Molly dumb as fuck, bro. Like, I don't understand that. Like, with all respect to what she do, she just be there. She don't say nothing at all. She be interrupting. And she'll shut in the whole set, the whole subject. And I'm like, bro, shut the fuck up. I'm going to hear Stephen A. cussing nigga out 5 minutes.
Yeah, like, bro. He's in his bag right now.
Like,
shut up.
I want to say, Molly, just fuck this show, bro. Nobody cares about the next topic. Bro. Fuck this show, bro. Like,
I still hit, though. Hey, did y'all know that today is hip hop's 49th birthday? Did y'all know about that?
49?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, mm-hmm. Man, 49 years old.
You know that. Happy birthday.
Little hip hop.
Happy birthday, hip hop.
Speaking of hip hop, though, man, let's get into this Irv Gotti on the Drink Champs.
He was the main guy in Murder Inc. who was dealing with like Ashanti and everybody who was signed there. And they made a lot of hit records, obviously, throughout the time. And I think the main point is just like him after all these years talking his shit about his situation with. Who was the main girl?
Ashanti.
And I ain't gonna lie, some of that shit sounds very creepy and very kind of like.
It's just like, bro, it's been 20 years though, bro. Why are you still thinking about this? So let's see this video, man.
So Happy, let me explain how the relationship and how it worked to.
Yeah, I'm dating at this point.
Yes.
Okay.
So we're together.
Matching watches. I imagine you bought her watch too.
I bought her mad shit.
Okay. Birkins, all that. All
right. I bought. She gained.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know about none of these. I just moved.
Okay.
So
you Switzerland. Stay out of it.
I'm Switzerland. Yeah, yeah, Switzerland. Yeah, yeah,
we just finished sleeping together. I'm taking a shower. I'm in the shower. You know, a nigga be creative after.
Yes.
I think of the whole track in the shower. I'm And she'll get on here and she'll probably, listen, right. She'll get on here, if you had her on Drink Champs or whatever, mm-hmm. she'll probably be like, I never fuck with Gotti. And she'll, I'm not going to do that. I'm like, but I'm going to give it to you real. Like me and her, dare I say, was in love.
I have my version of what has happened with me and Ashanti. She has
was Nelly piping her better than you or something?
I don't think that had nothing to do with it. I think that had more.
Just found out what the commotion is. Nelly has walked in with Ashanti.
You fucking are in love with. Is with this
name. It went complete viral. Irv Gotti says he's sleeping with Ashanti, which I never did.
So yeah. This guy has a real obsession with Ashanti, man.
Did he actually sleep with her?
I think allegedly, he probably yeah. did.
I think he probably did.
I have questions.
There's so many questions.
He got like, he really stressed, bro. Drink Tramp got away, that man bro. Drinking, boy. You bringing out true demons in him. He really felt that.
She the one that got away, bro. She broke his heart, bro.
Yeah.
Yo, and those are disrespectful questions talking about, is Nelly piping her better? Hey, yo, shut up.
That's like, crazy. That's wild to ask.
Why would I know that? That's
hey,
so
yo, like, I don't care about that. Shut up. Man, hurt. He feeling hurt after hearing that joke.
Like, damn, Nelly stole your bitch, and you don't know how to act.
But you could tell, like, that was the best part of his life was Ashanti.
Yeah.
Like, that's all he wanted to talk about is Ashanti. Like, bro, you don't have nothing else to talk about? You don't have nothing about
bro,
yourself?
And this nigga is married, bro. This nigga has a whole wife right now, and he's talking like this.
That's crazy.
Is he married? Yo, that's crazy, yo.
The disrespect.
Damn. Ashanti just living her life.
Yeah, she unbothered.
What can you say? That nigga weird, bro. Like, then that nigga had a whole clip saying they never slept together, and now he's saying they slept together. That's weird.
Like, bro, you corny, dog. Corny as hell.
Like, did you get the coochie or not? Like, god damn.
Like, okay, you hit. All right, bro.
Congratulations.
Okay.
Like, bro, that was like 20 years ago, bro. That was like 20
years
ago.
Exactly, bro. She was
imagine you still reminiscing about some coochie you got 20 years ago.
Like, what? Were you a virgin or something, nigga? Damn.
Yeah, bro. Like, bro, you can't remember what the box were like. Shut up.
I came with Happy in the shower.
It is.
That
was cool, too.
Mm-mm. But, all right, moving on, man. So, we got 21 Savage, man. He tweets that Atlanta has to put the guns down. Put the guns down, Atlanta. And everybody was like, man, what the fuck are you talking about, nigga? You make gangster rap. What the fuck are you saying?
Yeah. But think about some 21 Savage lyrics here.
Yeah, right.
Pull up to your mama house and just put 100 rounds in it, is it? Is that how it goes?
Some shit.
Pull up some on shit. Your block.
So my question to you guys is, can a gangster rap promote peace?
No.
I said, can a gangster rap? Can a gangster rapper?
No, I don't think you can. Like, there's certain things, like, okay, you remember, I think Tyler had said it before. He was like, bruh, some stuff is just not my place, bruh. Like, he was like, y'all want me to speak out about certain things? It's not my place. Like, you can feel like, yeah, they should put the guns down. Shut up. Don't tweet that.
Damn.
Like, don't. Come on now. You gotta know who your audience is. Of course, like, your whole audience is and people are shooting and killing people every 5 minutes. But you know what you're promoting, bro. Shut up. You can say that with friends. You're like, yeah, man, I don't think they should be doing that no more. Or, like, you got to show it in your community. Tweeting that helps me in no way, because literally tomorrow the song about how you about to go spin the block 5 times. So, like, come on now.
It's hypocritical.
It's super hypocritical.
You got to pick a side.
No,
you just gotta pick it.
There's no way.
Like, you know, you can't just sit up there. You make your whole album based off of getting niggas whacked,
bro.
That's your whole imagery. That's everything that's in the music. Getting niggas whacked, spinning the block, fucking a nigga mama up, going to his granny crib, and just doing whatever. If that's your whole message, bro, you can't tell niggas to put the guns down. You can't tell niggas to delete all your songs then. Tell niggas that.
Pull up to a block and then put a brand in it.
Like, come on, man. Or be more sophisticated and say, yes, I have made this music that does not align with how I'm feeling now. I believe y'all should put the guns down. Say that. But don't make it seem like you wasn't just advocating for fucking AK-47s and M-16s.
Mm-hmm. Pull don't up do with that. A gun with a actually.
What is he doing, Marlon? What's up with this nigga, bro?
Marlon don't want to get in this. He know we right.
I think y'all wrong. I think your whole thing. Whoa! I feel like, honestly, bro, if there's something on your heart and you feel like things are changing and you feel like it's really becoming a big concern, I don't think whether you portray the gangster lifestyle or you live the gangster lifestyle, I think that as a human, you're just doing the human thing or just letting people know that, hey, this is probably something that we need to change. I feel like it draws outside of just who you are as a person to make these, and he's using his platform to spread awareness. I mean, I get it. I get the shock. I get like, wow, it's kind of crazy. But bro, niggas changing, and he's an example of like a person changing through his wealth and through his experience. So bro, that's not the life he lives anymore. I understand that that's the life that got him to where he is. But bro, that's just not who he is anymore. He tell y'all niggas every damn day, that's not who he is anymore. So him telling y'all saying, hey, my city is changing, and let's all be real right now. Atlanta is changing at a very fast rate with the people that's coming there, with the experiences that are happening. Like bro, Georgia as a whole, but even Atlanta specific, bro, things are changing. And it's not as safe as it used to be. We all can sit here and agree to that. Like all you new niggas down there, I don't know. They fucking the shit for everybody else. So like, who am I to say you can't speak about that? I just feel like you're doing a human thing. You're not doing it because of who you are, you're doing it because bro, it's the right thing to do. There's two like, niggas dying every damn day. Come on now. And then he's more tapped in to the city just as everybody else. I can imagine he's having a lot of experience of people dying, people getting robbed, people having a lot of hard times, bro. The hood ain't safe. So it's kind of like, I get what y'all saying. I honestly and truly do. But I feel like it's the wrong thing to do.
So we're not going to act like we don't have any killers that was playing 21 Savage music in the car.
We're not saying that. I'm just saying the human thing to do is be honest about, just be honest. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like, bro.
Yeah, but you're not that guy, though.
How you know?
You're not that guy.
Bro, no, bro, because who is that guy? Who is that guy? You know what I'm saying? I feel like he's doing a human thing. Young thug.
Just go back to what I said with the whole Cardi B shit, bro.
I just feel like, bro, no, you can't do that now, bro. I feel like everybody.
You an artist, bro. Just make your music, bro.
No, bro.
Make your music, bro.
No, bro.
He not that guy. We not supposed to be taking advice from him.
It doesn't matter. If that's my platform, I'm using my platform for good. Bro, he can't be that guy forever, bro. He can't be a gangster rapper forever. It doesn't work, bro. It doesn't work. You can't put a nigga in a box forever. You're literally, as a black man, putting another black man in a box because of his experiences. Right. And that's not the right thing to do. Like, you gotta be real about that. We all change every day. He's telling you, I change, and I want to let y'all know, like, hey, bro, we need to make some change. Nigga, Young Thug is in jail. Young Thug Gun is in jail. Lil Key died. Like, nigga, things are happening at a fast rate in Atlanta, and it's not for the good of shit of their music community. So at that point, it's like, damn, bro, like, who am I to not spread my awareness to help the people? Because he's doing it for the city, so it's kind of like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I get what y'all niggas saying, but that's lame as fuck at the same time. Because it's like, then y'all get mad when them niggas don't step up to help the community at the same time. You're literally contradicting the whole point. He's trying to help the people, but y'all niggas are mad because he wants to help the people. Like, what the fuck? Like, I got all this wealth and I can't help y'all niggas now? Like, what the fuck?
That ain't how you do it, bro.
Bro, wait, I'm bro gonna, he didn't, just, it was I'm just a tweet, bro.
In the box.
It was just a tweet, bro.
There's nothing else here.
No, bro.
I gotta put him in the box.
Yeah, that ain't how you do that shit, bro.
No, what you mean? He spoke out about it. It's a lame
tweet. No, you're tweeting. Tweets don't go anywhere, bro.
Bro.
Tweets don't go no fucking where, bro. If you really want to make change, go to the streets, bro.
Bro, he probably already doing that shit now, bro. He's doing that shit now, bro. Come on, them niggas do all that.
Use the art, bro, to push your message. Bro,
he's telling you on my public platform, my public platform, that all y'all niggas saw, I'm letting y'all know how I feel. Bro, it's cool because y'all niggas want to dick ride any other nigga tweet about some wild shit, but the fact that he took upon himself to announce his shit.
He tweeted some wild shit.
But now I'm trying to use my platform for good. I don't, but yeah, I don't know. Y'all niggas different, bro. I just feel like it wasn't a bad thing.
That's like if Marlon, if you're a person that knows that I got 8 bodies under my belt, right?
Trippy.
And then I'd be like, I just randomly start being like, yeah, man, we need to stop the killings, bro. I'd be like, bro.
Bro, I'm not going to lie to you. Here's the thing, I'm not going to lie to you. As disappointed as I am about your 8 bodies, if you try to turn a leaf and try to do good in this world, and you want to promote stopping gun violence, bro, who am I to tell you that you can't change?
But then, granted, Carlin,
you are who you are.
Like, bro.
You are who you are. But I'm not going to judge you for wanting to make some change in the community, bro.
Oh, you're that giving too many passes, man.
I'm not giving too many passes.
You are, bro. Passes? If a nigga got 8 bro. Bodies, don't tell me about peace, nigga.
Don't talk to me about peace, bro.
You want problems? Don't talk to me about peace.
People make mistakes.
You kill somebody, mama. Don't talk to me about peace, bro. I don't want to hear that shit,
bro. You don't know why I killed a man, mama, man. People make mistakes, bro.
What,
nigga? You be hearing yourself, bro?
No. Tell 21 to shut up,
bro. Bro, people hey, make mistakes, bro. Y'all niggas are too literal with it, bro.
He did a good thing, bro.
I ride with you. These niggas hating on you, dog.
He don't fuck with you, bro. He don't fuck with you, nigga. Hey, let's get into this video with him, though, bro.
When I say something about how I really feel about Atlanta, like where I'm from, it's like a lot of gun violence, a lot of killings and shootings going on. And I ain't never seen nothing like this. Like, my whole life being in Atlanta, I ain't never seen it at this point that it's at right now. Babies getting killed. It's just, that's just sad. That shit make me depressed. When I speak up on that, they say, oh, you a hypocrite. You this, you that, you. I ain't never promoted violence. I just rap about what I've been through, or what I've heard about, what I've saw. That ain't me promoting violence. That's not me saying, yeah, violence is cool or whatever. Yeah, I say a lot on songs. It's catchy. People like it.
Don't do that shit, bro.
The contradictions, bro.
Don't cap, bro.
So it was all cool when you ain't had no money. It was all cool to talk that shit when you ain't had no money.
No, bro.
It was all cool when it was just niggas, but now that it's kids and now that it's women, now you want to act. Bro, stop.
Nah, bro.
Stop with the cap, man. These niggas be capped up, bro. These niggas be capped up, bro. I'm sick of it, man.
Come on, nah.
Niggas be capped up, bro. What he said was lame. Talking about, oh, I don't promote violence. I just talked about the life that I live. That's what you're doing when you put it in music. You're promoting this shit.
Nah, man. That's lame, bro. I'm good.
What you mean? How it lame?
What are you talking about, bro?
That's lame, bro.
How is that lame, bro?
He said that while she's lame.
Yeah,
what
he said was lame.
Yeah.
That's lame, dog.
How is it lame, bro?
Ben, you beat all the facts.
Man, you fucking it, bro. That's lame.
How is that lame, bro?
Yo, it came from his mouth. That's crazy.
How is it lame, bro? I'm waiting, dog. I'm waiting, bro.
I'm waiting, bro. I don't like that.
Ben, I'm waiting, bro. I'm waiting.
I gotta say, bro. I'm just
dumb. Yeah, exactly, bro. Exactly. Sit this one out, bro. Sit this one out, bro.
Nigga,
sit this one out, bro. You don't know what you're talking about, fam.
Man, 21 preaching that real shit. Y'all ain't lying, bro.
Hey, yo, that's crazy.
What you talking about, bro?
Bro, he got more. Straddling the fence,
bro. You gotta pick a side, dog.
Remember, he had Morgan Freeman on the album explain to you what a snitch is and what a rat is, and fully explained it. And then went to it and said, snitches and rats, they all get whacked.
Talking about some, he not promoting that shit. Nigga, stop. Damn, if you gonna lie to me, do it nice, bro. Fuck. Niggas just be lying to you. And this nigga's like Marlon that eat that shit up, man. Nigga will straight up lie to your face. He be like, yeah, you right, bro. You know what? You right. You have changed, bro. Oh, fool ass.
That I'm man literally head. Said it, bro. That's crazy to me.
Yeah. Ron like, all right, nigga.
Because I don't care. Because at the end of the day, he ain't wrong for what he did. I don't care what you say. Like, it don't change.
It's catchy. People like it.
I ain't saying
like, that.
That's how he's feeling his heart. Listen, bro, you ain't live that life and tell me how you feel, bro. I ain't mad at it. Like, damn, do I feel
slaughter gang shit, murder gang shit.
I'm not mad at that, bro. I'm not mad at him telling his story. Tell your story, but don't tell the next man how to live his life, bro. If you're not living the same way, bro.
He want the youth to stop, put the guns down, bro.
Yeah, but that's not how you do it, though. You don't tweet it.
Nah, bro, you gotta have like a song and be it. Like, yo, don't live my life like me.
Yeah.
You gotta explain it. Like,
show us that you really about that shit, bro.
Lil Baby told us that he about it. Yeah. What he did? Yeah. He made a song. He let y'all know.
Oh, pause. No. They get the same shit to him, technically.
Yeah, they did. He tried to put it in the music and be like, "Ayo," you know. He tried.
Lil Baby's a little different. A little different.
Now you make it.
Lil Baby don't be talking like he a killer though.
Yeah, bro. No, bro. Come on.
You don't be going in depth like he a killer.
That's apples to oranges, bro.
Yeah, not really.
No, bro.
If we had a gangster rapper list. 21 Savage is up there. Like, he's top five on that list, bro.
Duh. Mm-hmm.
Top five on the most violent bars. You know what I'm saying? So if you're that nigga, be that nigga. But don't try to switch sides now because you think, oh, shit's getting worse. Well, shit was bad when you first started.
Yeah.
Bro,
Niggas was dying when you first started.
He's bringing awareness to a cause, bro.
Now that he got his money, now he want to bring some awareness. All right, bro.
Y'all niggas kill me.
That shit fake, dog. That shit fake as hell,
bro. That shit is not fake. So you think he'll mean none of that shit?
He does now because he got his money. But back then, when he was broke and starving, fuck y'all niggas. I'll shoot all y'all niggas and your mama. Yep. But now that he got that money, okay, man. We gotta join together, brothers. Let's be on one accord. Shut the fuck up, man. That's fake ass shit, man. That shit fake as hell, bro. Wish a nigga would be. Bruh, fuck out of here. But,
I got the vinyl.
Damn.
What's that little red part on there?
This is the, it's a curtain. It's the version exclusive vinyl for Renaissance. It is here. I want the original. I want her more naked. She ain't as naked now.
You big horny.
She for real. Got clothes on now, bro. This the one y'all just got, bro.
They ain't gonna jack up to Beyonce, bro.
I just wanted the naked version.
Oh, I thought he was gonna say something.
Bro, I was like, yo! He should lean into it. That's the problem.
Put that in the thumbnail.
Put that in the thumbnail.
Show me looking at a vinyl.
You're a freaky
boy.
Yeah. Continue. But yeah, man.
Bro, like real shit, bro. I'm getting so sick and tired of y'all.
Really, nigga?
How are you not subscribed yet? You've been watching these videos. I see it in the stats. I see you guys. Like, I know who's watching, who's coming through. Hit the subscribe button, bro. It's free. The joint don't get no freer than this. Like, who wouldn't want to subscribe, bro?
You know what I'm saying?
We talking about that good shit. We giving you what you need, bro. You already watching.
It's free.
Hit that shit, man. Hit it. It's right there.
Sticking to the script, though, we got Kevin Gates. He talked about not trusting the Black Lives Matter movement.
Yo, Kevin Gates
Like, they got mad when I said, I don't support Black Lives Matter. Because who they matter to? We kill each other all day. We talk about each other all day. You know who talk about me the most on the internet? Niggas. Niggas. You know what's worse than a nigga? Two of them. Make you don't want to be a nigga. Yeah, man, it don't be nobody else talking about me. It be niggas, my own people that look like me. Can't wait. look at Gates. Went to jail, they celebrated, clapped their hand, it was happy. I don't look at color and see race no more. I see real and fake.
It's some Instagram, man, shit. Like, he was speaking on Instagram. I hate niggas who post like that. Like, I guess, nigga.
Yeah, man. Damn, well, bro. You gotta think, bro. Kevin been to jail. He done seen stuff, bro. Yo, there was a time,
bro. He just be whining, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you.
Nah, bro. There was a time where Kevin Gates was on top of the world, bro. And you know it, bar. Two phones, bro.
Come out of Yucatan,
Come on, bro. He was really in there. And then as soon as he went to jail, a little thing pop up. Everybody chained it back on that man. He was just like, all right, bro. I had to watch and see how it is.
Yeah. So what he said was facts, though, man. We don't care about each other, for real.
We don't.
And it's sad, bro.
Poor Kevin.
I just don't like that we live as niggas, unfortunately.
Damn.
Am I lying though? Like, bro, like, let's be real. Black struggle is some shit, boy.
Yeah. Like, it really is, shit. Man.
Like, really in like every facet, like, bro, you, I've seen this shit where it's like, oh, yeah. there's more single niggas than there's single women out there, and like all the niggas now, you full of niggas now.
Yeah,
it's like, bro. It just, I don't know. It's hard. Life is hard in a weird
way.
It's
getting bad, man. It's getting bad. It's a lot of reasons to that, though, as far as the whole dating app situation. But they were saying that it's more healthy relationships now, so that's why, you know, it's more niggas than it's ever been. But the average nigga is having a hard time getting a woman anyway.
Yeah, because it's because think about it. You're hoping that you get a good girl with like standards, and she's not for the money, and she's not. Like, y'all can grow together. You want somebody that you can grow with. Today's standards is like, bro, it's all about the image of what a perfect relationship is. And the idea of, like, black love and all that type of shit is not real. It's a false idea. I feel like that's some shit they feed you when you're in high school. You're fucking, your parents will feed you this idea of having a perfect situation. That's just never the case. You know what I'm saying? Like, as much as we can want that, desire that, hope for that, that's just not... It's
not but you know what it stems from, though, bro?
What
it's the programming, man. Women are programmed to all like the same nigga, so it's only gonna be a small percentage of niggas that's gonna get all the women. Everybody else, they're just gonna fall to the wayside.
And then you get what you get. And it's like, bro, you get the crumbs, and it's like you're not. And as a man, I can feel as confident as I want to feel. Dumb bitches don't want me. They ain't gonna want me. You know what I'm saying? That's just what the fuck it is, bro. And then if I want you, too bad, then I'm a weird nigga because I want you more than you want me. Like, it's when you really break
that
it down,
is like, bro, what?
That's just then bitches will. Okay, females will have, but even have the audacity to tell you, I only like a nigga if he like me more than him. Like, what? Yeah, I can't get.
They don't think about what they say. Sometimes they just say
no.
Shit,
they don't because
that.
They couldn't.
I mean, I can understand that little point. I get that. But.
But even then, but they say those things because they feel like, because they know, like, we're here for a reason. They know for a fact we ain't just going to dip after you say some shit like that. Mm-hmm. We're not. I don't know. Existence as a man is complicated because of how much barriers we got to, like, present to keep ourselves, like, straight. Even as a black man, where it's, like, a lot more at the same time, especially in the dating, it's kind of like, well, you got to pray. You better hope and pray. You get you a good woman, because if you don't, my nigga, I'm sorry. I hear this shit every day. I work around men and women who talk about their lives every day, like it's fucking the news. And this,
we just had Lori Harvey the other day talk about how she felt like that she didn't want to get married at a young age. She wanted to, you know, stay in the streets basically, because that's what everybody's doing. Everybody's not settling down right now, so why should I settle down? Oh, I'm settling. Settling is a bad thing. It's not a bad thing. You know what I'm saying? A lot of these girls today, bro, they scared to just be with one guy because they feel like they're missing out on something. What are you missing out on? That's what social media is pushing. It's like, you got to get the best of the best of the best of the best. And it's like, you're not the best person that you can be.
Damn.
How can you deserve the top 10% nigga? You ain't even a top 50% bitch.
Bro, like, bro, his thing,
world got messed up. Samuel, go.
Go.
And the bitches who are the top 10%, they fucking are single. Like, do you realize that? It be the basic bitches who ain't got a college degree, who ain't got nothing to their name, but you think because you got your BBS and titties and some nice
they
makeup.
Killed
you,
Kevin because he's
You think you worth something. I understand. Yeah. I'm not hating in the slightest, but y'all bitches standards for what the fuck you think you're supposed to get versus what you're going to get in reality, it'd be fucked up.
Bro, Marlon, we talking about niggas that don't, they talking about, they don't like average guys, bro. This shit crazy, bro.
And no. Understand. Then y'all be expecting an average 9-to-5 nigga to live to unrealistic ass standards, and it's like, bro. And y'all gonna get mad at me. It's like, bro, I don't get it. It don't make no sense, bro. Y'all be
saying you don't like an average guy. What's wrong with a decent man, bro? What's wrong with you, bro?
Bro,
I was talking to my homegirl last night, right?
Bro.
She was like, she was giving me an update. She was like, yeah, I met this guy. I got two dudes. One guy, he live in his auntie basement. He's 27. He ain't got no job. Damn. But he woke. he woke. So like he don't touch my hair type John. That's him. Oh. The other guy is like 20. He's 20. He does like movie lighting and stuff. And she's like, yeah, I mess with both of them. The 20-year-old one though, I will say that, cause he treat me like I don't know how. I ain't never been treated like. He asked me, do I want to get salmon? I was like, salmon is the point for you that you realize, oh yeah.
Yeah, bro, bitches don't eat salmon. Bitches don't get salmon like that.
But that's the fact that my boy ain't got no job, no nothing. She's like, yeah, but he was way better. And said, I was like, yo, you really almost stayed with my boy who ain't got no job. You was just chill. She's like, yeah, he's another guy. He feed me. I was like, yo, this is crazy.
It's crazy, bro,
the standard is low, bro. Tell you the standard is low. I keep trying to say, bro. Hey, bro, in this country, my nigga, and I'm talking to my niggas, bro, at this point, you'd be happy to get your ass a nail tech at this point, because, bro, you ain't gonna get no bitch with no real goals and aspirations. And I mean that with the sweetest way possible. Is the bar is like in hell, just a little bit.
It is, like, man.
I mean that. Like, cause when you get you a good one who really want more and who's not going to put you in these complicated ass situations, yeah, bro, those are the ones who get married. Those are the ones niggas love. But the ones, like, bro, we all know them. We all seen them. We all dated them.
Man, I was talking to somebody the other day, bro. They was like, it's not going to be our generation. It's going to be the next generation. I'm like, damn, man, fuck. It's like,
that's what? Damn.
It really do feel that way sometimes because it's just like, it take them too long to figure it out. They be fucking 39 years old with two kids and they figure out, oh shit, I do want the good guy now. I do want the guy with the stability.
But even then, it's like, bro, and then it's like, they never have a real reason to want, they never have a real reason not to want the good guy. They'll be friends with the good guy. They'll call him your best friend. They'll be like, they'll lock him down, but they never ever commit to the good guy. And here's the thing, right? The point is, right, niggas, every nigga ain't a prize. I understand y'all can want what y'all want. I can understand that. The gender situation, I get it. It's not, everybody's not for you. But at the same time, the way y'all carry it about dating and just relationships and just talking to people, it's weird. It's just, all the shit looks weird. Like, the standard is too low. And it's like, that's why people don't get, a lot more niggas are single, that's why a lot of relationships aren't working. And that's why, bro, you could say in your lifetime, you didn't date about over 20 bitches because, like, bro, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you'd be happy that you under 10. But I know niggas gonna be more than 20. Like, it's just, and niggas be cool with that. Niggas be cool with being with a bitch for a season and then you go, oh, you break up. You, like, this, it, bro, because we all low-key did it. We all, like, had a toxic moment where it's like, oh, man, bitch. Like,
yeah.
Bro, it just happened, bro. Like,
man,
it just
happened, bro. Stories, bro.
I can tell y'all some story, bro. I'm telling you, like, and it's, you know it's wrong, but when you, that's just how life was accustomed to. That's just weird, bro. Like life, the bars and
like it's crazy you. Because this girl, right? This was like a while ago. I was talking to this girl, man, and I had like, you know, I had the lineup and shit. She was in the lineup or whatever, but she was really trying to argue with me about the fact that we had been talking for over 2 or 3 days, and I'm supposed to ask her out on a date. And I'm just like, number one, we haven't been talking consistently. Number two, I don't know you like that.
Yeah.
You're not entitled to a date. And that's the problem with today's society. Like, motherfuckers are entitled to shit. It's sad, man. It's sad out here, bro.
They ain't entitled to nothing. But every time a nigga be like, well, shit, if you want these things, give me this. It'd be a whole argument. It's like, bro, and I'm saying, you want this money? You want this attention? You want all this shit? Give me some coochie, bro, because that's what the boy down to. And I swear to God, it'd be a fight every time. No, you won't have my coochie, but you want my millions. Like, stupid, bro. It don't make sense.
And they don't get the part that it's like, bro, you go out there and you work for that money, bro. This shit is not falling off the tree. I work for this shit.
Degrees. I bust my ass, and you coming here with your no degree, you can't say that, Marlon.
They got degrees now. You can't say that.
The ones who got degrees are not in relationships like that. There's a statistic. The higher they want, but I know a couple of them. The ones who really be having it, they be single, and it's not. And I don't get like the connotation of why that is. But bro, like, man, bro, men be getting like bitches who can't do nothing. Half these hoes can't even cook them how. was kind of like,
I tell you, my boy living in the basement 27 still getting him some. He ain't doing nothing. Yeah.
I don't know why he's still in the basement though.
Hey, bro.
He don't gotta improve. You know, he gonna get some pussy. See, he'll improve when he realize he ain't get no pussy.
There we go, Marlon. Yeah, that one click right there.
Say it again in the back for the people in the back.
I'm just saying, bro. A nigga will change his occupation in his life real quick without even getting a pussy, boy.
I know this is gonna sound crazy, but that's the truth. If these hoes stop giving up their pussy, niggas would elevate. That's just the facts. But they giving up their pussy so
and
easily.
That's sad. That's really sad, man, bro. Like, that's just what it is. Like, that's just what life is that, bro.
He said they would elevate.
Iron style.
They would elevate, bro. Niggas would level start up. Levitating on us, bro. Real shit. Niggas would start levitating.
At least have a car, bro.
Real shit, bro.
He didn't have a car.
At least.
That's fucking crazy. Pussy got that man like that, bro, in a fucking grip.
I'm chilling.
That's sad, bro.
Man, you wanna know who I think is the most player niggas on the earth?
Who?
The ones who got bitches and they gotta walk places.
No, for real, bro.
Yeah.
That shit crazy.
Yeah, they be
walking to the bus stop, boy.
You see it, like, shoot, the whole family be walking to the bus stop. Like, bro, you gotta be a player nigga to have a bitch and to have no car.
Bro, how you getting around that in Uber? Uber is crazy, bro.
Uber ain't lit like it used to be. So, bro, imagine the shit you gotta do. Uber.
Man, I took my first Uber ride with Ben. Just for the people to know.
Where did we go? Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. Is that when we went to go get shoes and shit? Was it that time?
Was it that time?
Oh, besties.
Yeah, like, yo, that was when Uber was like, $5 for a ride. I was like, okay.
Yeah, man, now. That shit was so cheap.
$45. Where you trying to go?
Uber Eats used to be so cheap, bro. Niggas used to survive off Uber Eats, bro.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Uber Eats used to be cheap too, man.
It used to be so cheap, bro. It
used to be $12, bro. That shit.
Like, legit $12, bro. I used to live
with some fries.
Like, 2020 and 2021, I used to live off Uber Eats, bro. That shit was lit, bro.
Mm. But hey, man. Speaking of some weird shit, Doja Cat.
Yeah.
Doja Cat, she shaved off her eyebrows, y'all. You heard about that wrong?
She had a mole under her eyebrow, bro.
Yes, sir.
Did not know that.
Yeah.
I feel like people care too much. I feel like, bro, yeah, Doja Cat's a weird bitch. Okay. She's a weird human being. I think weird bitch is too aggressive. She's a weird human being. And I feel like people don't understand that people can change their style, change, do what they want to do. It don't mean niggas are like got problems or niggas are sick. Like, bro, this is what she wanna do. She's a pop star and she's a weird one at that. But like, bro, let her do what she gonna do. She's like, bro, people would know shit. There's something wrong with her. She just quirky. Like, every time she do some shit, she post some weird shit. She quirky, bro. Like, what she is, she in it. Like, she's not a nigga. And it's kind of like, bro, she just hooked. She's Doja Cat.
She's still
like,
fine.
I get it.
Don't get it wrong.
Not anymore. Bro. When she first came out, bro, she was bad, bro.
Bro, she's better now. What do you
she
mean?
No, sir. No, sir.
She definitely came out, she was thick.
She was thick, bro. She was thick, bro.
She was thick.
She was thick. She was thick.
Now it's like
she's like
where your boobs at?
Now she like pop star thick. She pop star thick. Like now she she got shape. She ain't got no fitness to her. She got shape.
I don't think she really cares about her physical appearance anymore, for real. Like she just like
She just be doing how she feels, bro. And there's nothing wrong with that. I feel like people need to stop making everything a viral moment. She's not sick. She's okay.
She's perfectly fine. Was she probably on that coke? Definitely.
Damn. Bro. But everybody do it, bro. All the artists do it. You can't tell me artists.
Damn, bro. Man, they ain't doing no coke.
I'm convinced that it's certain, bro. Artists be having
parties.
That's
what Kendrick was doing out there running around with Ferg.
You think Kendrick ain't doing no drugs, bro? Kendrick get high, bro.
Who, Kendrick? High.
Bro,
Kendrick, hell no.
Weed, bro.
Nah,
I ain't gonna lie to you. the one part about being an artist I would want to do, I just want to be outside, like, really just messed up. And I know I got all the security. I got everybody around me, so I can just be messed up on purpose. Like, bro.
Right, yeah.
I'd be stupid. Like, I'd be all the part. My pictures would be wild. Thank God,
Kendrick,
damn, bro.
That nigga Kendrick falling off, bro.
Bro, he's just posted in the bro. Hood.
Why you hanging with ASAP Ferg? Oh,
why can't he hang with Ferg, bro?
He was hanging with Ferg. Ferg is lame. I think he went to bro, like a Ferg birthday party for Dapper Dan, and then did a performance for Kendrick for Jay-Z and Beyonce.
That's love every time. Every time for the time. That's love. I said I do this for my culture to let y'all know what a nigga look like, and I put a proof road.
Yeah.
And I'm like, but like,
which was pretty cool.
Which is cool. But then, Kendrick, why are you outside doing pull ups in the middle of the street in New York, bro? Kendrick,
with ASAP Ferg, bro.
Bro, why
are you hanging with ASAP Ferg? All New York niggas. Come on, man.
Niggas can't hang out with Ferg, bro.
Nah, no. Bro. Ferg is wacky.
Ferg is somebody. Ferg is somebody to them rappers.
Man, fuck that. I prefer ASAP Rocky. Damn, at least.
Yeah.
Hang with ASAP Rocky, not Ferg, bro.
Rocky keep you cool. No. Rocky gonna keep you driving, bro.
Ferg.
Well, he might give you a gun, but.
Bro, I'm gonna say this, bro. I think that whatever that Kendrick purse was, whatever that purse was that Kendrick had, bro, it came from Ferg, bro. That's really what happened here.
Oh, for sure. For sure.
Said, bro, I got this in my trunk. You want it? I guess. Get that man up.
Bro, you know you had all that money. You can do it too. I don't care what anybody say. If I had, if you had all that money, you'd be wearing weird shit.
I'd wear a back.
Yeah, I would. I would wear some weird shit. Yeah, for sure.
I would, bro. I swear, I wouldn't even recognize what y'all talking about. I would wear like the wildest boots, the wildest coats, bro. I would just because I know I got the money to do it, and nobody can tell me nothing different.
Like, yeah, I dress some weird shit.
It's like bitch, this coat $13,000. Nigga, shut up.
Hey, man, so we got the NFL star Odell Beckham Jr. He talks about beating depression with willpower. So do y'all think it's that simple? Just got to will yourself out of it.
Yeah. Okay, which one of our depression?
Will yourself out of it with the bread, bro. I got you. I'm like, you can give your side to depression, you know, and that's great. Speak your truth, bro. But not everything works for everybody. It's willpower, bro. Some people really ain't got no willpower, bro. They just be going with the flow of things, bro. Let their body do as it pleases, bro. You know, I'm glad that he's gotten over his depression or is getting through it.
Yeah.
No.
I mean, honestly, bro, I think depression is the lack of willpower. I mean, so to say that all you need is willpower is kind of like counterintuitive because you don't have that. You can't just get something that you don't have. So I think, like I said, it worked for him. Like you said, Rod, he's rich.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of hard. I ain't gonna say it's hard to be depressed when you're rich, but it's kind of hard to stay depressed when you're rich. You got everything you wanted. You know, you got the nice lifestyle. You're a champion now. You know, you got all the baddest bitches, you got a family, you can provide for them. I mean, eventually you're gonna stop being depressed. Like, you're gonna start thinking about how good your life is.
Yeah.
But when you just an average person, you ain't got a life like that, you ain't got a wife, you ain't got the kids, you were incel, you stuck in the house. It's kind of hard to just climb your way out of depression. And so to just tell somebody all it takes is willpower, it's a little it takes way more than that, bro.
Yeah.
It takes way more than that. What you think about it, Marlon?
Depression is really complex, right? Because it can show up in so many ways. I think that he's articulating in the best way that he can. Because I feel like depression hits everybody. And it's a weird thing that you can never really explain what it does to you mentally and how it's going to affect you going forward. But I do believe that shit, he had, just like with other topics, he has his right to just to explain the best way he can. I do feel like it does take a certain amount of willpower to get yourself out of these slumps. Because life is hard. Life is difficult. Life is not what it used to be for different generations. Like, it's a little harder, bro. And so it's so many different scenarios that we're going to jump into in life that's going to really challenge our mental toughness and our willpower. Like, that's just what it is. We can't avoid it. We can't escape it. There ain't never gonna be a human being on earth who will say I ain't never had depression, because bro, it's there. It shows up in so many forms, and then you can be living your life every day, be thinking you pushing for it, and bitch, in reality, you're depressed. More than depressed. And it's like, bro, that's scary. That's a scary thought. So shit, I can imagine as a football player, imagine I have all these millions, and I got all this wealth, and I amassed all this fucking money, and I am still fucking depressed. Like, I have it all. There is nothing I cannot do. I'm on that fucking backup, bro. Do you realize how much shit is at the tip of my fingers, and you're telling me, like, bro,
that's and you know scary, what's crazy is it's shit. Actually that can make you depressed. Having everything so fast will make you depressed. So that's probably what he went through
like,
as well.
I feel like there's no middle ground. I feel like you really poor, really rich. I feel like nobody really wins when it comes to depression. I feel like depression manifests itself even in your happiest moments. Because, like, bro, you just – and sometimes like, even the richest niggas then kill themselves over some shit they can't figure out. The mental stamina really be challenging. Like, bro, life is difficult. It's really difficult.
Yeah. It is, man. But speaking of some depressing shit, right? So we got Ruby Rose, man. Ruby Rose went on Aiden Ross's live stream to talk about people saying the N-word. So,
yeah, question. Are y'all surprised about that?
Slightly, yes.
I'm not.
Slightly, yes.
No, because she's like the racially ambiguous girl. I can get it. I can get you to say that.
Racially ambiguous? Like, is that the term you use for this woman?
Yes,
I mean she is though.
Ambiguous. She's not claiming like I'm black. She's not, and she would claim foreign before she claims super black. So it's like, bro, she's racially ambiguous. She isn't like, bro. We'll put her in black culture, but she's not verbally identifying with black culture.
She just
profits off of black culture.
Is being gay a race?
Being gay is not a race. Being gay is a choice.
Make sure y'all ain't on that
wave. Being gay is a choice.
Oh, people saying that?
People think that.
That's weird. It's the wrong way to think about it. I feel like it's just a choice. And it's a determination.
Like how Jewish people be like being Jewish isn't really a race. It's really a religion. But they consider themselves as Jews. They think of themselves as
it's an ethnicity, but it's not really.
Because like you could be Jew, you could be a Jew but not be Jewish. You know what I'm saying?
How is being a Jew a ethnicity?
Because
it's like a bloodline type of thing.
The place that you're from, the place that your bloodline is from.
And then being Jewish is a bloodline though. It's like a
bloodline. Yeah, it's a bloodline. It's a bloodline.
You see how they get y'all? No, bro. Stop that.
It's a bloodline.
Bro.
What you mean?
So you try and tell me, I'd be like, okay, white is considered a ethnicity in a sense, right?
Mm-mm.
Or is that a race?
It's a race. It's a race.
Okay, so being white is a race. So the ethnicity of a white person who is Jewish, or a spicy white person is what we might call it. Like something funny.
A spicy white person.
Like, oh yeah, he's like that's
no,
what I heard
no, bro.
Like, if you're white, Jew, bro, and you're
he's not white
from Spain,
anymore. He's
you're white
he's
and you're
Jewish.
From Spain. What do you call? What do you say?
Spanish.
He's Spanish.
Spanish person.
Bro, I'm not falling for the Jewish thing, bro.
No, it works.
What do you mean, bro? What do you mean you falling, bro? What are you talking about, bro? Because
being his thing. No matter where he is in the world, he's still a Jew. Bloodline thing, bro. It's a little different.
It's a bloodline, bro.
I could convert to being Jew.
This is why they be winning, bro, because they were able to trick y'all into thinking these things, bro. It's just crazy.
Bro, it's a Jew. It's a bloodline thing, bro. No, you know it's true.
Tricking us into what, though, bro?
into allowing them to be whatever they want to be, bro. No, bro. They are not. It's a religion, bro. It's not a whole.
It's a religion, bro. It's a religion followed by. It's a religion followed by a certain group of people.
Ethnicity, bro. Are you getting what I'm saying here? So you're saying
you gotta think,
that
you
the
gotta
religion
think.
Enters your bloodline and it makes you Jewish?
Nah. It just
or are
so
you
happens
saying that,
that
because they're from Jerusalem,
the people of that bloodline had a religion under the same name. Yes. Just like why you had the Nazis killing the people from Poland because they were Jewish. They're Jewish. Because of their bloodline. That's it. It's just so a bloodline.
That doesn't mean that your religion becomes part of your bloodline. That's just something that your whole family was following.
The same word for two different meanings. That's all they're doing. They're using the same word. Like if you part of Judaism, then you were Jewish. If you were in the bloodline, then you are Jewish. But they're two different things, though.
It's a cap. I don't believe them. I don't believe the Jews, bro. They just do what they believe.
They do, but it's okay. They do though, but it's okay.
How you make your own? How you make a religion, a race, and an ethnicity, bro?
Bro, because they can.
They can,
and they got all the money too. And they got all the money, so you really can't tell them shit.
For some reason, I kind of thought that you're Indian or like Middle Eastern or something. I don't know.
What the
but
fuck?
You're just light skinned. I don't know, but yeah. So
wait, Ruby, do I look light skinned?
Isn't your hair curly?
Yeah. Wait, hold on. Does that mean I can? Say
no.
I'm personally okay with anybody saying it as long as their intent isn't to be rude, because I'm sure Aiden, you have a lot of black people on your channel, you like black music probably, so as long as the person isn't saying it with malicious intent personally, because I have like Mexican homegirls and white homegirls who be saying it, I don't care about other people, you know, other people would find something wrong with it.
Yeah, Aiden, let it fly there, shit, fuck it.
Fuck it,
motherfucker.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, fuck. Okay, Ruby.
Does he actually say it?
Nah, he's not gonna say it. He ain't moving like that.
Because he ain't stupid. Smart. His partnerships would get his ass.
Aiden is smart, bro. He got too many black people in his corner to be doing that type of shit.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But, yeah, man. So she said, if you're not being rude about it, then you can say the word. What do y'all think about that?
Don't say it. Just don't say it.
Let's be real, right? We can talk, because this is like an old conversation. I feel like, bro, but who say it? I don't want people of the race to say it. That is how it makes you feel.
No, it's only people of two races that I don't want to say.
Yeah,
what's the two races?
Yeah, but it's like, bro, the same
white people, and that's every version of the white as I just spoke of before, and Asian people.
Damn, why not the Asians?
Stop Asian hate,
they
bro.
Don't fuck with us.
They don't fuck with us, but still.
They don't. Yeah. At all. And they know goddamn well they don't. Yeah. Really, I don't really mind Mexicans. I'm like, hey, yo, if that's how you feeling. You kind of in there somewhere. You've been through some stuff.
They are technically, but still, like. I don't want nobody other than niggas to say it. I just feel like, bro, but she said it wasn't a wrong thing. I feel like that's the way that she feels comfortable with the N-word, and she has that right as a person of color. Fine. So, but the thing about it is, just because a person of color gives you the right to say it does not give you the free will to think that you could be letting that bitch fly like it's cool. Because just because I gave you the N-word pass don't mean just be saying it at your convenience, bitch, because it don't work like that. But we don't say the N-word all day. We really don't.
Say it if you want to. That's all I'm going to say.
Your life ain't going to be easy for you after you say it.
Say it at your own risk, bro.
You want to be oppressed? All right. All right, then. All right, y'all. Pete Davidson and Kim Kardashian. They split up after 9 months of dating.
Skeety.
We already predicted that they would split up, so that's not really new. I don't think so. I think she's gonna move on.
I think it's gonna. Yeah, that's true. She probably
gonna hold on. We knew she
gonna. She gonna get a version of somebody who looks just like Kanye.
Damn.
Mm-hmm.
She might get back with Kanye though.
I hope not.
Please don't.
I hope not too, bro.
Don't give Kanye what he thinks he deserves.
Kanye gonna wear that shit in y'all niggas' faces.
Yo, Kanye going to show his ass. It's gonna be wild. You gonna be like, bro, come on now.
He really is.
Gonna have a whole nother grand ass wedding.
I need Kanye to step his damn swag up, bro. What's up with these fucking boots and shit, man? Why is he doing this?
He left the black culture, bro.
Bro, that's cool, bro.
That shit whack, bro.
Fashion, bro.
He said he left the behind, bro. He don't care about that no more.
Bro, that shit crazy, bro. Molly, you remember how he used to dress, bro? You remember how he used to dress?
Pink polos with the backpack.
I ain't even talking about that. I'm talking about that fucking My Dark Twisted Beautiful Fantasy shit, bro. Like, that shit.
Yeah.
He used to dress hard, bro.
He's in a whole different energy now, bro. It's a little different, bro.
We going running space, around, bro. Blackface on, ready to go to space. I don't know.
Bro, I ain't gonna lie to you. Yeah. Y'all see a little different than me. But I ain't gonna lie to you. If I'm an artist, bro, I'm trying all the weird shit. I just feel like at a point, you it's like gonna everything. Get boring for me to keep doing the same. I'm not like everything. I'm a person. I like change. I like everything. Creativity. I like originality. Like, cause I feel
you
like
do as like an everything, artist, though, bro. Bro, like, when have you like said you did not bro. Like some shit, bro? Real shit, bro. When have you said you what don't you like something? Like, when what have you saw what? Somebody's style and you said, I don't like that shit? You don't say that, bro, because you like everything.
Bro, because it never comes up. What are you talking about?
This nigga right here.
It never comes up. It never comes up, bro.
I don't like it, but you don't wear it, maybe.
I can tell you something.
Nah, he don't even say that. He'd be like, man, that shit hard.
But I can tell you some nigga style who I don't like.
Who style you don't like?
Kid Cudi be playing like on the like a little too much. I feel like Kid Cudi ain't.
I don't.
But I feel like he played like on. No, bro. Because you said name somebody. I don't like how Travis Scott be like. He ain't got no.
You don't like Travis Scott
at all. He should be. I don't like his. Sometimes his drip be lit, and sometimes his drip be like it look average to me. I feel like Ben could step out and call the field from Travis Scott if he had the money. I'm like, Travis need a stylist. I feel like Triple Red can't get Triple Red to wear on fucking pajamas all day. He ain't got no drip.
Bro, stop it, bro. Trippy got fits,
but it's like, bro, that's too far in between. He want to be alternative at the same time. Triple Red ain't got no drip at all.
Really?
Ain't got no drip.
Triple Red ain't got no drip?
Man, I'm a big fan, but I know it's Trippy ain't got no drip. And it's okay, but you ain't got to have drip. But as a rapper, you guys
ain't got no drip.
Kendrick definitely got no drip.
I disagree with that.
You think Kendrick got drip, bro?
A little bit.
Bro, you saw the fit he was rocking in the hood?
Very basic.
Very basic.
Yeah.
Very
it's like on that J. Cole kind of, you know, I'm going to just put on whatever type shit.
And that's not drip either, bro. Niggas be like, that's drip. That shit look garbage when J. Cole do it. That girl should be baggy as fuck. Bro, you're not a bum, bro. Get a retweet. Do something. My nigga look crusty,
get a retweet.
God damn,
that nigga look like crusty.
Like, bro, I understand, bro. The bitches be loving that shit. I was like, bro, he looks like a bum, bro. If you didn't know this nigga, you think he a bum, bro.
Mm-hmm.
That nigga got, like, imagine you a millionaire and you didn't got no drip. Like, that shit is crazy.
And yeah, like, that is some crazy shit.
I think most rappers can't dress. I really, honestly and truly, I feel like most rappers cannot dress. Even the ones who think they be... Even the ones who be swearing, they in the high fashion shit. I don't think they fits be going that crazy. I don't think Brent Fires fits be going that crazy. I just think because y'all hoes love him. That like
it
should be clean. He should be clean. I'm gonna get that. He should be clean, but they don't go that crazy. He be acting like he just needs to put that shit on. Like
shit.
I don't like that, bro.
Jacquees, bro. Jacquees be looking dumb as hell, bro.
Jacquees should be looking. It'd be looking sweet as hell. That orange fit. Y'all know that orange fit I'm
talking
about.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, that's exactly what I'm thinking. Like, yeah, bro. Like, looking like a bitch, bro. Too short for that, bro.
And then
looking like a bitch, bro.
niggas be thinking because they artists, they can get away with that. No, bro. You look goofy as fuck.
Look dumb
I know
as
you
hell,
in a, I mean, you're a land nigga, bro, but come on now. Like, bro,
like a fucking
real
minion.
Right now. I'm just saying, bro.
Like
niggas
fucking
got
report
to Willie
Wonka, boy. And then, so Kanye, he trolled Pete Davidson.
Yeah.
Online, you know what I'm saying? Saying
Pete and Cudi at the same time.
Yeah, at the same time. Pete Davidson went into trauma therapy after that.
I don't know. That's the sad thing about this.
It don't matter, bro. Yeah, it don't. Damn. It don't matter.
It don't
bro.
Matter, fam.
Mm.
It don't. Kanye won. It's,
I know that's kind of funny.
Kanye wins.
Imagine you get bullied by a nigga who's 40 years old, and then you try to fuck his bitch and think his bitch was gonna leave you.
Like, nah, bro, she gonna go back to where the bread at.
Come on, now.
Got 3, 4, 5 texts of her.
And Kanye got like 4 kids with the bitch. You think she really gonna like, stay with you?
You just a card.
She wants big time, bro. You ain't got Kanye money, bro. You ain't got easy money,
it's
bro.
Like, what was you thinking, bro? You know she moved from
bro,
nigga to nigga. You know that.
And then you try to marry her. Bro, y'all only been talking. Y'all were talking
for
9 months.
Y'all wasn't even boyfriend, girlfriend. Y'all were talking for 9 months.
Like, bro, what are you doing? Why are you trying to wipe her hoe?
You was her rebound. She was trying to stretch her legs again, bro. She just wants something
else
a little bit.
That's it. That's it.
Hey, but she's not gonna marry you, bro.
That's it. Like, she got kids with somebody else, bro.
You Pete Davidson. Just had them kids. You're not that guy, bro. You Pete Davidson.
Facts. Crazy as hell,
bro.
But hey, man, if y'all could fuck on one celebrity for one night, you only got one night. Who are y'all picking, man? Who y'all fucking on, bro?
A wild question.
You only got 24 hours, bro. Who is it, bro?
I'm calling SZA, bro. I gotta call SZA, bro.
Call her SZA, bro.
I call SZA, bro. Like, she be looking crazy. I be like,
that's a good pick, man. That's a good ass pick. Oh my god.
Either I would say Snow.
Oh.
Snow Allegra.
Okay.
Okay. Or Doja.
Damn, bro. Rod, no. Repick, man. Repick.
No.
Not Doja, bro.
Bro, I don't pick Doja, too. Doja.
No, bro. It's too many baddies out there for y'all to be picking Doja, bro.
No.
Doja is bad, bro. I'm trying to tell you, bro.
Yeah, she bad, but she not top tier, though, bro. Stop.
It don't matter, bro.
She not top tier, bro.
Prime Doja was lit. Prime Doja was fine, bro. Like, that ass, bro.
Okay.
She, and she told me to snort some coke off her
titties.
I do it.
Bro, I'm trying to tell
you. I do it, man.
She don't even like y'all, bro. She like white
boys. It don't matter.
What talking about?
It don't matter. It don't matter,
You're going to get that call.
I'll be the first. I'll be her first.
She's just going to be looking at you, dog.
It's okay, bro. I'll change her, bro. I'll bring her back to the dark side, bro.
She's going to have y'all playing Uno, nigga. What the fuck is you talking about?
Okay, and I'm going to play Uno with that coochie, bro. I'm cool, bro.
Nah, she's not letting you hit.
Reverse.
You gotta color your skin.
Okay. I'll paint myself white.
I beg your pardon. I beg your pardon.
Oh, you cooning now. You cooning.
Or if it's not Doja, I'm going for Megan. I'm going for the stuff. I'm going for Big Fish Theory.
I feel like Megan will hurt you, bro. I feel like she's just too big, bro. Megan is huge, bro. Like, it's scary.
She is a big girl.
I just want her to say, ah, that's it. That's it.
Oh, you lay. Oh.
You saw she dropped the project.
Yeah.
You gonna listen to that, Ben?
Allegedly.
You disrespectful.
Allegedly.
You disrespectful, cool.
Man, my pick, man, I'm going for Megan Good, man. Give me Megan Good.
Bro, you are old dusty coochie ass.
Yeah,
Megan,
give me Megan Good. Bro,
Megan ain't even good now. You lying.
Yeah, she is. Don't cap, bro. I'm putting a picture up there. You gonna see it.
Oh, bro.
You look good, bro.
Post that picture she posted the other day. I mean, she was fine.
Megan Good is a fine woman.
Being she good, fine, bro. But like she OG fine.
Yeah, so. Jill Scott is not a bad pick, bro. Right, if there was a big girl that I'm hitting Jill Scott, bro. If there's Jill a big Scott. Girl I'm hitting Jill Scott. Jill Scott is nice.
Yeah.
She's nice with it.
Jill Scott, yeah. Go right there. Bro. Crazy.
Man. Big old titties. Speaking of titties, though, so we got Rod Wave, man. Rod Wave talks about taking himself on
drugs. You going to hell. Watch your ass, bro.
Speaking of titties.
You took yourself off of the Lemon Pepper Freestyle. Weren't you supposed to be on that record?
Yeah, cause a nigga like Drake have to understand, bro. I got your CD for Christmas. You know what I'm saying? At that moment, I was shocked. Like, I still was adjusting to the shit. And he sent me a song, and it took me like a week to even just record it. I was listening to it. I was like, I don't know what to do on this motherfucker. We recorded it, and I heard it, and I just was like, man, I don't like this bitch. I want to come harder. I want to get in there and do some shit. Like, you feel me?
He's like, I can't do it.
I got this man CD for Christmas, bro. Yeah. I'm a little boy watching this nigga. You feel me?
Like, this is wet. My boy
Wayne. Hard time. Off of
him. You can't do nothing but respect, bro.
Man.
Be honest, bro.
He being honest. Like,
I heard
like
that shit,
he's
bro.
Not like, I'm just going to give Drake anything.
Bro,
you know what I mean?
Imagine how bad it's on the band. That should have sounded terrible if he just gave him anything.
Yeah.
That's a fact.
So I'm happy that he didn't just give Drake anything. But then that also gains Drake's respect, you know what I mean? And mm-hmm. Drake, all right, cool. So now, bro, we're going to get a Rod Wave and Drake song just exclusively soon enough.
Now he. Lemon Pepper beat is hard to sing over, man.
Yeah.
If y'all remember that beat, that shit is hard to sing over. So I can get where he coming from.
I can't do that. I'm Stanley. That's cool.
But
y'all bumping the new Rod Wave?
No, not yet.
Are you going?
This is too many songs, man.
That's what I'm saying, bro. I'm planning to. I just can't. I can't get with this, man. Like, I hate that our attention spans are so short now. But 24 songs—that's a lot.
That's a lot of shit, bro.
And I'm not
recycling topics.
Mm-hmm.
Like, come on, man. How many songs is actually going to talk about something different? What, like 4 or 5? Come on, bro. You could have made the album 12 songs long.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. But speaking of songs, right?
Mm-hmm.
DaBaby. DaBaby gets on the cross in the new music video, Tough Skin.
I stopped listening to DaBaby, man.
Okay.
Why?
It's like he's entering this realm where I'm like, I don't care.
You know who he makes music for real though?
Who? Wow. Wow, that's
I know it sounds crazy, but yeah.
Let me see this video. Make...
yeah, trust me.
Let me see.
Just push that back. Just push, there you go. There you go. All right, lift up.
Oh, that shit
hurt. The air ain't really kept it from hitting me.
Right.
You really got him stressed out. You worried.
Why is he looking at us like that, bro? Why?
Bro, why his chain burning, bro? Is the cross burning? I have questions. He's just trying to get back into the light, man.
Do what you gotta do, bro. I can't hate. I just don't care.
Do what you gotta do. It's cloud chasing for sure. It's cloud chasing, man.
Do what you gotta do, gang.
Yeah.
It's just like, why do we gotta play with Jesus? Why we gotta play with Jesus like that, bro? Jesus is the most abused savior of all time, bro. He is the most abused religious leader.
They don't expect him to come back, bro. They don't think he's
gonna
come back.
Nah, real shit.
Like, they ain't gonna have to deal with that, man.
What you gotta do, gang?
Why? And I watched the video, bro. It has nothing to do with that, unless he's saying, you know, I guess going through hard times was kind of like how Jesus went through hard times. I guess that was the parallel he was trying to make. But it's like, bro, why, canceled. Bro?
I remember he got canceled.
Yeah.
Because he said stuff
insensitive.
To the alphabet team. He
need to canceled again.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's crazy.
Cancel him, though. You just can't cancel him.
Because the baby.
Yeah.
Mm-mm-mm.
Getting on the cross, though, Ra?
Yeah, it's kind of disrespectful, bro.
It's like, come on.
To a whole group of people's religion, bro.
Yeah.
It's like, come on, man. Stop.
But we didn't have that same energy for Kendrick, though.
Bro, I feel that way about Kendrick, too. I don't like it. It's weird. I don't like this, man. It's not the way. Bro, it's going to be sad. Because I feel like my end of the year, when we do like our end of the year albums, Mr. Morale's still going to be up there somehow.
Oh, of yours?
I have some weird reason. I think I'd be listening to the album just looking for why this album so bad.
Yeah. It's because you're loyal, man. When you're loyal, that's just what happens.
I just be sitting here listening,
bro,
to
them. I'm not going to lie to you. It's not. Mr. Morale is a big step. Okay, it's weird.
Stop.
It's weird. Stop. No, I'm not. No. I'll be honest. It's not what we wanted in the slightest. But for what it is, it's cool. It's cool. I'm not. After seeing the shit live, it's cool. I'm gonna just say it's cool. I'm not saying it's any like his greatest body of work, but it's cool. I'm not gonna just be respectful to say that, but it's like
N95 hard though. I ain't gonna
lie. Bro, this shit's hard, bro.
This shit's hard.
But it wasn't what you wanted. It was nothing like what we wanted.
Yeah. You took too much time off, man. You just lose touch when you take that much time off, man.
He'll be back.
He just got really weird. He just got really weird.
We waited forever for that shit.
And then goddamn was just like,
what? And they said that Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers is a play on Jesus and the disciples.
Go to the next topic. I'm about to fight Kendrick.
I don't know what to say.
I don't care that he do.
I mean, I get it, York,
bro. Fuck Kendrick.
Damn, bro. Damn, this nigga saying fuck Kendrick. Damn, bro.
Cause, bro, he irritates me with that project, bro.
Damn, bro.
Irritates me. It irritates me when I think about it. I should have been able to listen to that album all year, bro.
Speaking of long-awaited albums, though, we got Lil Wayne. He's finna come out with the Carter 6.
What up, y'all? Tucci here. Thank you. I ain't shit without you. I'm not sure if you heard, but Carter 6 is on the way.
Yeah.
Okay.
Carter 6. Damn, nigga said okay. Damn, it's man. Wayne. Music is changing, Wayne, bro. Niggas is not even excited no more.
Bro, why am I excited for Wayne, bro? He just be dropping random stuff now. And I just be like, okay, thanks, Wayne. What was it, Funeral?
Mm. Yeah.
What's that random thing? Give us the Carter 6. You know that's what people want.
Funeral was good, though.
I didn't listen to it. I don't listen to Lil Wayne.
That was Project, a good album, bro.
I don't listen to the Wayne Project. So that's
shit bumping a whip. Well, I'm looking forward to it.
I know.
I'm looking forward to it.
You know. Yeah, I'm a Lil Wayne fan.
Oh, I'm not a heavy Lil Wayne fan like that.
Yeah, you're a heavy Wayne fan. You know all the mixtapes, don't you, Ben?
Couple of them, yeah.
He's not too quick.
One of my favorite, I will say, one of my favorite Wayne projects was I'm Not a Human Being, Part 2. I do enjoy that project a lot. It's the intro. That intro go crazy.
The Carter 3, though, bro. The Carter 3 and the Carter 4. Oh, man.
It is. Yeah. I hope so. I know that's what people will say, though. Like, the Carter 3 is, like, their favorite. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, y'all, let's get into this last topic, man. So, podcaster believes that most of the women in his community have multiple kids by multiple guys, and that it's unfair to people like him. So,
people like him.
Aww, yeah.
No, they don't want to have, they don't like you.
You ain't get no coochie.
Niggas say, oh, you ain't get no coochie.
Most of the women in my community have kids by another nigga, and it's unfair to people like me who work hard, and now I gotta provide for another kid. Like, nah, I can't. Every time I meet a new woman, I get to know her. She got a kid. She got two baby daddies. She got three baby daddies. Ain't shit. Her mentality is all fucked up. Now I gotta work 10 times harder for something that somebody else got for free.
But that's what you attract, though. Women with children.
No, that's the majority of the women in my community.
And what you think majority of men have? More women have multiple baby fathers.
Future has 8 baby mamas. Who's the sexually irresponsible one? Future or the baby mama?
Both.
No, it's one.
No.
It's 8 women that know
both.
That. No, it's one dude.
Do you feel
dude.
The same way with Nick?
Yes, I do feel the same way with Nick. It's one that's sexually irresponsible. You got 8 women that's sexually irresponsible. Who y'all?
That last part, bro, my man thirsty. First off, my boy thirsty. He a little hurt. He mad he having to work for these hoes. Secondly.
He in New York.
He didn't lie to what he said about Nick Cannon and Future.
In my community, they got kids.
What do you mean he didn't lie about it?
About this being sexually irresponsible, because you got 8 women pregnant. That is being sexually irresponsible.
Yeah, but she was saying both of them are sexually irresponsible.
No, I agree they are, but the man, he probably is the most sexually irresponsible in the situation.
Oh, okay, yeah. He wasn't saying that, though.
You are sexually irresponsible being baby mama number 6, knowing he has 5 others, and you know who he is, and you know what he does. You're being very sexually irresponsible to bring a child into this world who's not even going to be in a 2-parent household. And then they can be doing it, and he knows he's actively doing it, and he doesn't even care. It'd be a new bitch pregnant every other month.
And don't they kind of have like some sort of disease or something?
Where he has some sort of disease where he might not live long. And he,
yeah, that's crazy.
That for not,
bro, if Nick can't live in Canada? Oh my God.
That's crazy. Saying,
like, think about that. Think about that. And like, he's on every show, he's making the bag. But let's be honest, bro. Like, that nigga just be having kids for the sake of having kids. Mm. It's not about creating life.
It is creating life. My man said, I could die any moment, bro. I got to leave some nuts around here.
You can't get you can't get though. You can't get 8 kids the same amount of love.
8 kids, though, bro. And you're not even gonna be here for them,
bro. You're not, bro.
That's kind of selfish.
That's very sexually irresponsible.
Hey man, he can only do so much. He said he gotta leave his seed somewhere.
Okay.
No matter where.
Okay.
That's how he
feels. What do y'all think though? Do y'all feel like more black women in our community are having multiple kids by multiple guys? Y'all agree with that?
Man. He needs to shut up saying it like that. My community, they think a kid. I can't go to her house without having to step on a goddamn Lego. Like, come on, bro. Yeah. Shut up. Women in general going to have kids, bro. Yeah. White girl going to have kids. People just going to have kids.
I honestly want you not to date somebody with kids.
Then make that your standard, bro. Don't get mad at them because they got 5, 6. Oh, sexually irresponsible because I got.
They deserve to have love too. Shit, just because she got 3 kids don't mean she ain't deserving of love, bro.
She just had three situations in her life, bro.
Top three. Most women are not having multiple kids by multiple guys, though. Like, let's stop the cap. Let's stop the cap.
In my community,
definitely not today.
Yeah, are more of them having kids at a young age? Yeah, sure.
Yeah,
like they've always been, but not multiple kids by multiple guys. Like, that's not really going on for real.
That's not accurate.
Yeah. So I mean, look, man, if you can't get no pussy, just say that.
It's okay, bro.
Just say that.
It's okay, gang. You ain't getting no pussy, gang. Okay.
It's okay,
but
kids.
Yeah, man.
It's okay, gang.
Yeah. Let's go ahead and conclude it on that message.
Yes, sir.
That's episode 85, yes, man. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, man.
We like any last words. Y'all watching, sharing a little bit. We seeing some of the numbers grow, man.
Yeah.
But don't stop there. Keep showing that look.
Yeah.
Won't stop. Let go.
He said, yeah. This nigga so disrespectful.
Yeah. No, I ain't saying that. My last quote is, yeah. Don't die for another nigga's bitch. You know what I'm saying?
That's
you like, but I ain't gonna lie to you. I was like, no, I gotta keep that in. He did that.